Hi there, do-it-yourself enthusiast. Today, I have an exciting project lined up for you. We're going to light up this dark stairway using LED light strips, an ESP32 D1 mini board, and WLED software, and integrate it all discreetly under the stair railing here. Not only will this brighten up your home, but it'll also add a touch of elegance to your staircase. Let's go. Okay, so first thing, let's talk about some of the supplies we're going to need. One of the first things we're going to need is some LED lights. So I used these WS2815 12 volt individually addressable LED lights. Next thing we're going to need is we're going to need a ESP32 board. I used this WROOM32 D1 mini board. Next we're going to need a buck converter. This converts the 12 volt power supply to the ESP board down to 5 volts. And then we're going to need some LED channel. So I use this 6-pack of LED channel here. And of course, we're gonna need the 12 volt power supply. So this is a 12 volt, 5 amp power supply that produces 60 watts. And lastly, we need a little project box so that we can put all this ESP board and buck converter all integrated into a nice little box. I'll put links in the description for all the parts we need. My first step in planning was prototyping by first assembling the LED strips with the LED strip and the ESP32 board and testing it out under my stair railing to see how it works and how it looks. So I started in my Miro project board. Let's take a look. So the first thing I did was lay out the drawing of all the different parts that we needed to connect together. First, we have the DC power supply on the left-hand side, and you can see the buck converter here is next, and the ESP32 board is then connected to the LED light strip. Here you can see that the 12 volt power supply runs both to the buck converter, and it also runs through the ESP board, but not connects to the ESP32 board, straight out to the positive and the negative of the LED strip. And then from the buck converter, it downgrades the voltage from 12 volt to 5 volt output from the buck converter to the ESP32 board. So you can see here as we zoom in that the power wire, the positive wire is coming into VCC and the negative wire is coming into the ground. And notice that there's a best practice here of connecting all of the grounds together to have a common ground system across the entire system here we're creating. And then finally, the data wire, the green data wire, is connected to GPIO 16, and that just comes out and connects to the data input wire of the LED strip. Notice also a second best practice here is that you should not leave the backup data wire, the BI, backup input wire, floating with nothing connected to it. The best practice is connect that to the ground, and that way it's not floating. Here's how I'm thinking about laying this out so that it all fits inside this project board. We'll have the ESP32 at the bottom, have the buck converter here on top. We'll have the main 12 volt power wires coming in all the way in. Those will be the two wires coming in. These will then connect to the positive and negative ground, and then connect to the buck converter. And then the buck converter will connect to the ESP board. And then I'll have power wires going all the way through, coming out, both the load, the positive and the negative. And then we'll have one green wire connected to the data wire here coming out. And that will then connect to the lights over here. After I soldered the power supply wires together and connected it to the buck converter, I used a small Phillips tip screwdriver and my multimeter to turn the voltage down from 12 volt to 5 volt. It took some fiddling, but I got it to exactly 5 volt output. Tight fit to get everything all crammed in there and squished down enough, because this has to go down far enough and not connect to anything below it so that this can go back on top. Got it all wired up, temporarily anyway. We'll figure all this out to make it neat and tidy looking once I figure out the final placement of it. This is just more for prototyping and testing. Okay, got a prototype all set up in here and temporarily just taped up to the bottom so I can see what it looks like. This is what it's off. This one is turned on. That's at full white brightness of these lights. So lights up pretty darn good. Curious to see what it looks like at night. After testing and being happy with my prototype, the next step was to work on the stair railing. To make this installation look professional, I needed to route a long groove under the stair railing to attach the aluminum LED channel that would hold the LED light strips and the diffusers. The railing is long. It's 14 plus feet long. So I set up two long tables and used two C clamps, one on each end, to hold it down. I also had to create this router edge guide you see here in the video, which allowed me to guide the router straight and make long grooves that I needed. Okay, this thing worked actually really good. I was surprised, and it was made kind of short work of it actually. I made three long passes all the way down from here, this end, all the way down, put it under that end. You can see that it did a decent job all the way down, got it right where I wanted it, down to the end. So next up is I'm taking the wiring and starting to figure it all out and what I need. So I'm putting this channel in here like this. Wire's going to stop here, run all the way up to that end up there. And then I'm going to, or the LED is going to start here and run all the way up there. And then I'm going to have the wire come out here and go through a hole I just cut in my, or drilled in my wall all the way through and come out the other side. Next, I attached the channel by drilling and countersinking holes for small flathead screws. Then I wiped the channel clean with isopropyl alcohol and attached the LED strips with their adhesive tape. The final step of this process was to insert the diffuser into the channel. This will help diffuse the light and give it a sleek, finished look. The final step was reinstalling the stair railing and routing the wires through the wall to the ESP board and the power supply, and tidying up the wires with some cable connectors mounted to the wall. The next step was powering it all on and testing out the new look. This is the cool bright white lights. Although they look pretty blue in this video, they're not that blue in person. And this is the warm soft lights. I think I like the cool bright lights better. And there you have it, folks, a do-it-yourself LED stair lighting project that not only illuminated your stairway, but also adds a touch of modern elegance to your home. With the LED light strips, ESP32, and WLED software, the possibilities are endless when it comes to lighting effects. I'm not done yet. I'm going to get an occupancy sensor so I can automatically turn on and off the lights when someone steps on the stairs and integrate this into my Apple Home Smart Home. That will be another video. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe for more cool content. If you have any questions or want to share your own LED lighting projects, feel free to leave a comment down below. And thanks for watching. Until next time, take care.